just stuff some wool in your ears. I don't hear it.
Enough of this!
Are you serious?
Racket is going to drive me mad. Do something about it.
Oh, just stuff some wool in your ears.
On it.
I aren't the officer. It is no simple manner safeguarding ordinary men from mages. And mages from themselves. Each circle tower must have some measure of self-government, for it is ever the maker's will that men be given the power to take responsibility for our own actions. To sin and fail, as well as to achieve the highest grace and glory on our own strength. You, who will be tasked with the protection of the circle, must be aware of its work. The first enchanter is the heart of any tower. He will determine the course his circle will take. He will choose which apprentices may be tested and made for mages, and you will work most closely with them. Assisting the first enchanter will be the senior enchanters, a small council of the most trusted and experienced magi in the tower. From this group, the first enchanter is always chosen. Beneath the council are the enchanters. These are the teachers and mentors of the tower, and you must get to know them in order to keep your fingers on the pulse of the circle. For the enchanters will always know what is happening among the children. All those who have passed their harrowing, but have not taken apprentices or mages. This is where most trouble in a circle lies, in the idleness and inexperience of youth. The untested apprentices are the most numerous denizens of any tower, but they more often pose threats to themselves due to their lack of training than to anyone else. Knight Commander Saren, the Chantry Templar, in a letter to his successor. Cool.
Let's get started. Right.
Come on.
As you wish. Oh! Ah! Oh! Ah! Ah! get started.
Especially each other.
The solution is so simple. We kill.
Are you serious?
Kill everyone. Right.
Thank you. many times have I tried it so far? not be under the misimpression that magic is all powerful. There are limits, and not even the greatest mages may overcome them. No one, for instance, has found any means of traveling, either over great distance or small ones, beyond putting one foot in front of the other. The immutable nature of the physical world prevents this, so no, you may not simply pop over to Mithraeus to borrow a cup of sugar. Nor may you magic the essay you forgot in the apprentice dormitory to your desk. You will simply have to be prepared. Similarly, even when you send your mind into the fade, your body remains behind. Only once has this barrier been overcome, and reputably, the spell requires 1/3 of the delirium in the Deventer Imperium, as well as the lifeblood of 700 slaves. The results were utterly disastrous. Finally, life is finite. A truly great healer may break someone back from the very precipice of death, when breath and heartbeat have ceased, but the spirit still clings to life. But once the spirit has fled the body, it cannot be recalled. There is no failing of your skills or power. It is simply reality.